break it down. Look at this thin thing. All right, let's check out these new retro. Hello, YouTube Nation, and welcome back for yet another toy review. This one's not so vintage. We got the new official Tag Team 2-Pack WWE Hasbro style action figures. This is the DX box. Look how thin this is. I got a box from WWE and I did not have a clue of who or what it was. Is this? So we're going to rip into this. So if you look into the back of it, a black and white. I'm not sure why that is. I would have thought they would have went kind of this green and black, but, you know, saving money and whatnot. So in this, we should have a Triple H. We should have a China. We got Billy Gunn and the Road Dog, Jesse James. Packaging, it's got that vintage look to it, which is kind of cool. So let's rip into this thing and see what we got. We have the flap open, and I am terribly shocked these are in here, actually. And this is packaging 101 right here. This is good stuff. All right, let's take that to the back. So when we do open it up, we have... My first impressions are those are just awesome. That is good times. Vintage style Road Dog, vintage style Billy Gunn, China, and we got Triple H. Looking at the card, let's look at China and Triple H first. This is China's first retro. Triple H has had some reissues in the past. They do have the flaps to where these will, the packaging will actually stay intact and not be useless. They do have some action. Pull back Triple's arm, pull back China's arm in the match with Hunter's hook. The ninth wonder of the world wallops anyone in the way. This is officially licensed, as you could see. Maybe I don't know if you could see that or not, but it's up there. I dig them. Let's take this one out. Let's just start right here. Let's just go with it and see what happens. So, DX, for me, ranks up pretty high. For me, of factions that are up there. Like, they're four horsemen caliber factions. No, I don't like this. All right, so they taped. See if this is easy tape or not easy tape. This is stupid. If you're going to have this kind of packaging, don't tape it. It's going to rip the packaging. I luckily don't care, but as you can see, because of this one piece of tape, my box is now forever damaged because they decided to tape this. That is a stupid design. Don't tape it. Just, you did good of being able to just pull it out like that. Don't ruin it with this. One little piece of tape or more. Okay, we got them out. Okay, so out of their plastic cage, they're looking good. Let's look at Triple H first. All right, so Triple H pops back. He's got that kind of soft plastic hair. Arm is rotating the leg. Doesn't feel like it's going to, but he got the Triple H hook. Let's hit it. Face sculpt. I mean, you can kind of look right there. That's a pretty close face sculpt, in my opinion. They got the smirk down absolutely 100%. Very nicely done. Trunks. I don't particularly remember these trunks, but I'm not a gear guy to where I remember what everybody was wearing or if they didn't wear it. I do know that if I just saw this in a bucket of toys, of random Hasbros or just anything, I would know, hey, that's a Triple H toy. Cool knee pads. Got his logo. I mean, Triple H was branded. Logo, 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 logo. So that's neat. Again, not too much of a trunk guy. I don't know if Triple H would have had a DX logo maybe somewhere, but it does have the X in the middle. I don't know if that camera is going to pick that up, but right there's an X in the middle of the swords right there. I don't see it. Up, it's on his butt, and you can see it there. So, really, really good. Triple H, that's an awesome figure. This one is actually the one, I probably should have done her last, but this is the one that I'm really interested in. They are in there now. Whew. All right, did the paint wear? All right, no paint war. Whew, good. All right, so China, standing him up. All right, that's about right. She's real thin, which is good because this is. No. All right, so she's real thin. She's got some good looking. I mean, the stand next to him. Oh, does she stand? Uh-oh. Oh, she can do it. Woohoo! The face, again, kind of using the back here to the face. That's a pretty good sculpt. Got an uppercut type motion. The waist does also go. So she actually has two motions that are. Oh, we got. Oh, look at this. So on the back of mine, let's see if we can get that off. Yeah, it comes off. Okay, that's just kind of a tapey residue. It's gone both back arms. It'll come off though. The detail on the choker chain with the spikes and the collar looks exactly like the box back there. Has the handcuffs on the trunk right there. Has some knee pad-ish type things. I've got some boots. Again, I don't know too much about gear or trunks or anything else, but there's nothing really to talk about DX with that. Love the figure. She's going to go in great with this line as I set them up there. All right, let's jump in to the road dog, Jesse James. All right, as we bring Billy Gunn and we bring in the road dog here to have a little peek, see their card, essentially the same. This one pops more because of the color. Not a lot of the green colors on those. I'm going to have to do, maybe I'll throw a picture up here or something to try to find those trunks. But these are the DX tag teams champions and the tag team. I loved them together. They really did throw them together, and they're just goofy and fun, and boy, did they fit in DX. This one also has a piece of tape holding this bottom. Let's see.
2 hours later.
Yep, there we go. One, look at that little piece of tape. Ruins the packaging. One little tape. Fantastic job. Whoever invented this packaging, you are an absolute legend, but putting tape on the absolute legend is not good. Let's go Billy Gunn first. So this is a big deal to get a Billy Gunn figure from a WWE line because he's in AEW. It's a weird thing. Let's see what's on the back of this first. I didn't do that. Knockout from the New Age Outlaws. Get the 1-2-3 from the D-O-double-G. I will say, like, look at this. This looks like a generic figure of how they're not detailed on the back. I didn't notice that on the first card. Here in a second, we're going to look at Road Dogg, and he is very detailed on the stuff. Even Billy Gunn has got some stuff on his knee pads. Just the back of the card is very generic. But these guys, they don't have to go into too much detail on that because they're not hanging on a shelf peg. They're not doing anything of that nature to where somebody's going, oh, look, that guy looks neat. Let's buy him. So Billy Gunn, again, I think he looks very, very exact to what that era of Billy Gunn looks. Billy Gunn has got the Ted DiBiase, Jake the Snake Roberts arm. He's also got a Tito Santana tour. The last time I did this, it flew off in a short. That was funny. got the green trunks with the baby kisses on it. Got the kisses, the BGs. And then he's got the X. So he's got DX on the boots. You can see the detail of awesomeness there with the little D in silver with the X on the boots. Oh, yeah. Great, great figure. Great figure. That's looking good. Now, after opening these and having a little peek-see, this one right here is really intriguing. Because this thing is just to the guild of detailed and just has some stuff. All right, so first off, here's the first negative I have. He's a jumper, okay? I hate the jumper figures. There's not one jumper figure that I like in any of these lines. They were all lesser action figures to me. Now, the expression up here in the box is not what's on this, but it does look like it. He has the dreads, got that shaved back part of the head. He's got the goatee. He's got the earrings. That's the Road Dogg. I don't know about the face, but That's okay. So we're going to start off with him. He's got his, I think it was a Tasmanian devil. It's his United States Marine Corps or his military tattoos, and he's got stuff on that. That looks great. Look at this t-shirt. Look at that. The Road Dog Jesse James. Look at the paint that's on that dog with the dreads. That is fantastic detail. Fan-frickin-tastic. And then a little nod to the Degeneration X up there right by the neck. That is awesome. And then on the back, nothing but it is a jumper to where you go. Now, weirdly enough, this is a spring-loaded to where the neck doesn't show. Like Brutus the Barber Beefcake and stuff, the neck gets draftish long. But this one just goes up and down. Kind of cool. Got his hands taped. Got the trunks. The road. And Road Dog. Got DX's logo. Got Road Dog on it. Got the X. RD. I think it's fantastic. Now, putting all of these together, and I know they're missing one DX member, and that's that Shawn Michaels. Will we ever get a DX Shawn Michaels? I don't think we've got one. Maybe a third party, but I don't know if WWE will ever release it by itself, because it could have been in with this, and I think it would have been a bigger seller than what these were. For me, these are 10 out of 10. I don't think there is one bad figure in this. For me personally, that's number one, that's number two, that's number three, and Triple H is number four. That's my order of how they would go in order of just good action figures of what they look like all the way down. I can't wait to add them to my collection. Comment down below, did you all get these? I'm sure they're still available. Nobody really sells out on the WWE Network all that much, but they're worth a pickup to me. All right, well, until next time, I hope you enjoy this from the DX Retro line. This is the Hot Pods Channel. Peace out, Home Skillets. Certain people that I know, they ain't no longer about. My name came up a lot of sounds. More when I was.